Thank you.
Jody's going to do for us today a stuffed, braised, whole breast of prime veal. Here it is.
This is the part of the veal that includes the brisket and the plate, and it runs from here in your body all the way down.
You can feel that rib.
Feel the last rib, which is the 13th.
You probably have to order. You have to order that.
I think so. I don't know that you find it in the supermarket. This is on the large size. It's about 13 pounds. They come a little smaller as well. If it won't fit in your pan, which I think this won't, you need to measure it and then trim it. Thank you. So see how it's going to fit? And the brisket end is the end that has more meat on it. So that's the end. That if you're trim anything, you want to hold on to that end. It's the shorter end. And then look to see how many you're going to need to cut off. And I think here it's about 3. Now I trim off the really flat part of that fat and leave some of the surface fat on because it will help baste the meat.
Mm-hmm.
And I said 3 ribs. So start by cutting these off. And it comes off very easily.
It comes off very easily.
Whoops!
You could, if you wanted, you could bone it or have it bone. It isn't too difficult to bone.
No, it's very easy. This is just a flap of meat that's sitting on the bones, the ribs.
But I think it always has more flavor with the bone in.
I think so.
It's still like the real butcher always sharpening your knife. If you want to get anywhere, I have to.
And you have a lot much less likelihood of cutting yourself if your knife is sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Go straight down, and if you're going to angle the knife slightly towards the bone so that you don't accidentally cut through the meat. And make a pocket, stopping right about an inch at the end of each rib. Kind of cut around the cartilage here.
Yes, that's interesting, though, that you can see right in there. There's that, all that cartilage there.
Mm-hmm. And we'll trim that out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this is the part that gets a little bit awkward, but you want to make sure you get your hand. So you can see I've cut to within about an inch here, but I need to go a little farther here.
Mm-hmm. Let's hold that up. You can see the whole. There's a real, real pocket in there.
Yeah.
Yes, and there is lots of good meat up there.
Right, and a lot of this, it looks very fatty, but this braises for 4 hours. So, most of it, a lot of the fat is just going to render off.
Yeah.
Of course, those 4 hours, and you can get rid of it. But this is not lean cuisine.
No. Well, you don't have to have lean cuisine all the time anyway.
Okay, and now work on the stuffing.
And this is...
That's about 2 medium onions, 2 cups of onions,
mm-hmm.
and 2 tablespoons of garlic.
And a little bit of olive oil.
A little bit of olive oil.
So it's really soft.
Yeah. And then we have ground veal.
Ground lean veal.
Ground lean veal. And pork.
Mm-hmm. All of which you can get at the supermarket.
Yeah. Pistachios. Whole, and actually I think I'm producing now. This has cooled. It doesn't have to be stone cold, but if it's hot, it will start cooking the meat.
Yeah.
Some breadcrumbs to help hold everything together.
That was about half a cup.
And then pecorino.
Pecorino cheese.
I'll stir all this together.
Oh, it's smelling nice, and this is only the beginning.
And I'll chop some herbs, have some marjoram.
It's wonderful that we can get fresh herbs now, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. I'm just putting in a little bit of marjoram, then thyme and sage. So this is thyme now.
Well, that's thyme. Yep.
This is the sage.
That's the sage.
and save the stems. The stems can go, excuse me, can go right into the braising pan. And this should be fairly fine, the herbs, so they get evenly distributed in the stuffing. Parsley, I think it's about 2 tablespoons. That doesn't need to be.
Is that Italian or
yes.
Italian. That has a little flavor, I think.
I think so. I like the texture as well in my mouth. It's pretty, isn't it?
No,
that's pretty. Okay. Now I'll put
in good.
The mortadella, about 6 ounces, which I'm going to eyeball. It has nice peppercorns in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's about 6. If it's a little more, that's okay. And next, the provolone. This is beautiful. Oricchio provolone, which is...
Well, that's in Wisconsin, isn't it, Oricchio? Yes, I visited there once.
Cut 3 ounces.
Exactly 3 ounces.
Exactly 3 ounces. Then I'm going to cut off the rind.
Mm-hmm. Is that again to be diced?
Yes. Same size.
So that'll sort of keep little piece in. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that'll be nice.
Okay. And now we're going to add the peas, and that's it.
Those have been already cooked.
No, what I haven't. I haven't put any pepper in here. I think maybe I want to put a little pepper in first. I love pepper.
13 grind.
13 grinds.
Heat up our tasting pan.
Okay, here we go.
Watch it for us.
Now, while we're doing this, we get the vegetable for the braised.
Fine.
Okay, these are the garlic for the braised, and I like to come straight through and leave them whole like this.
Good, because there's flavor in the skin too, isn't there?
And it holds together.
Yeah.
And I wash it first, just as you would any other vegetable, and it's together nicely. Like
I think this is done now.
Okay, that looks done. Okay. Wonderful the way you can see the provolone starting to melt in.
There's a fork here.
Okay.
Think there's enough salt?
I think it could use a little.
I think so.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. Okay. There's some kosher salt.
Yeah. It's easier for me to use because my hands get so sticky.
What's the difference to stick it out?
Mm-hmm. Can you please put a little oil in there? You can put those
in. I'll watch those.
Watch those.
These are for the braised.
Yes.
I love braised food because once you get it going, you don't have to keep washing it.
Mm-hmm.
It just kind of cooks by itself.
Hey, I'm going to bring back the breast.
Oh.
Would you like to put some salt and pepper in the vegetables, a little?
Oh, okay.
Would you
put some on that stuff. That really looks wonderful. I think you wouldn't have any idea why anyone would want to eat something like that.
No. Okay.
I don't want me to hold it.
Sure.
That would be wonderful.
If you could hold on
with
to that.
Your bare hands. A little piece of mortadella.
Okay. And then you need to really squish it down. And then I massage it a little.
Uh-huh.
So it's nice and neat.
a good idea. I'm sure it makes the breast feel better.
Yeah, I think so. Now, I'm going to put this straight on the board, so if you could move it, otherwise it'll slip too much. Start by make one tie like this. This may not be.
This is quite butcher's twine.
Yes.
Thin one.
Thin one, but you can use whatever you take. Just need, make sure it's cotton.
And it hasn't been waxed.
Right. And nothing
and
with
you
plastic.
You can get it from your butcher.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes these get caught on the
bone. Bone.
I like doing this. There's something very satisfying about seeing the stitching going.
Very neat, I think.
Yes. Once you're towards the end, it gets a little easier. I've reached the end of the ribs here. So Julia is going to flip the animal over.
Uh-huh.
And come back and do a little sort of slip knot over each.
Well, really pulled it.
That one. This is a rustic dish, so it allows.
Well, I think they're becoming more and more popular. Real food.
Yeah. And, you know, if we were really fancy, we could stick bay leaves under there.
Oh, that's nice.
And now we need salt and pepper. I'm pretty generous with the salt and pepper on the outside of the meat because it will fall off
yeah.
as it cooks.
Mm-hmm. Luckily, all that dish about no salt is gone by the board. If you're a healthy, fine person, you can have a normal amount of salt.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
Here we go.
Am I going to the oven now?
Now this will go in and just cook at a high temperature so the meat browns, and then we'll add the liquid.
So be sure to measure your pan, your oven, before you start on this, don't you?
Yeah.
Now this is at 400.